for tonight's performance by the National Chamber Ensemble. Please join us in welcoming President of the National Chamber Ensemble Board, David Wunderlich.
Good evening. Thank you for coming to enjoy this beautiful music in this spectacular setting. We are thrilled to be here. The National Chamber Ensemble's fall season is rich, diverse, and upon us. So now is the best time to visit our website, nationalchamberensemble.org, to find out about exciting events and to purchase season tickets. Please visit our website. There's a lot more to find out there. Also, we have live performance CDs and t-shirts with our great logo on them available for sale in the back after the concert. And now it's my honor to introduce tonight's musicians. They will perform the music of Dvorak and more. And the first is one many of you may know, violinist and National Chamber Ensemble Artistic Director Leo Shashansky, and also pianist Carlos Rodriguez. So please join me in welcoming them. Thank you.
Thank you. It's great to be here and to open the season, our season at the Kennedy Center. Now, the two of us are actually not the whole National Chamber Ensemble. We are not the result of the government sequester either. The National Chamber Ensemble is a society of internationally acclaimed musicians who all live in the capital area. And we come together in various combinations and sizes, whatever the music demands. And actually, there are over 40 artists that have performed with the National Chamber Ensemble. But we thought we'd come to the Kennedy Center in a pretty intimate and fun performance. Our first piece is by Antonín Dvořák, the great Czech composer. Now, Dvořák was on a teaching tour of the United States, and he fell in love with an American art form called the Negro Spiritual. He thought it was a fascinating genre, and he thought it was truly the American art form. And in fact, he said that a lot of the spiritual's tunes were as great as any tune that Beethoven ever wrote. And the piece we're about to play for you was actually based on spirituals. The second movement of this work, he wrote at a place called Minnehaha Falls in Minnesota. And he didn't have any paper with him, so he wrote out the movement on the sleeve of his shirt. So we're lucky it didn't get laundered away. But we're certainly happy to perform it. It's a piece that's fun to play and definitely fun to listen to, so enjoy. Thank you. Now, I thought we would do something that's pretty rare, basically throw some party music in the middle of a serious performance. And by composers whose names both start with P, Piazzolla and Paganini. Now, Piazzolla, he popularized the tango throughout the world, and Paganini popularized the violin throughout the world, being one of the greatest violinists who ever lived. So both works are a lot of fun. We're gonna do a little tango, and then two sonatas by Paganini, one in a minor key and the other in a major key. Most people don't know that Paganini was an amazing guitar player as well. And so we're lucky he wrote a whole bunch of wonderful sonatas for violin and guitar. For this piece, we're going to have Andrew Powell join us. Now, Andrew Powell is playing classical guitar today, but he's also a big rock star in Moldova. So please welcome on stage Andrew Powell. Even though these composers lived a couple of centuries apart, they're not too far apart in spirit.
Thank you. Thank you.
more time, but please. Okay. Now, for the final selection for the Schumann Sonata, we're going back to drama. Robert Schumann is considered to be one of the greatest composers of the Romantic period, and he wrote some fantastic music. He also suffered from depression, so a lot of his character sometimes falls into the music where you hear a happy motif, and then suddenly it's sad. Well, he wrote the sonata very appropriately the second week of September in 1851. So it's most appropriate we're performing it now. But he was not happy with this piece. He was dissatisfied. He says, I feel displeasure with this piece, the sonata number one. So I wrote another one, sonata number two, which I hope will be better. But sonata number two is very rarely performed. And luckily for us, this is the favorite sonata. But you know, he was depressed. So. Anyway, please welcome back Carlos Rodriguez. Thank you so much. I just wanted to tell you a quick word and maybe play one short selection. On November 9th is the opening of our seventh season, and it's a very special concert called Jewish Musical Treasures. It also happens to fall on the 75th anniversary of Kristallnacht, the night of shattered crystal. So it's going to be, it's not really going to be a concert about the Holocaust, but it's going to be about the contribution of Jewish composers and Jewish music to culture and a celebration of music. And so now we'll play for you actually music that's a contribution to Jewish culture, but in a different way. The music of John Williams and the theme from Schindler's List.